1983, the first well-known modern chess trig was made somewhere most people wouldn't expect, South Africa. Developed during a time of canvas and metal fittings, the South African Defense Forces Pattern 83 brought new materials like Cordura, Velcro, nylon webbing, and plastic buckles to the forefront of military kit. It went on to inspire chess trig designs for generations to come. In 2021, we did a major redesign inspired by the original to give it the upgrade that it deserved, which we named Pattern 84. Since its introduction, we've used the Pattern 84 chess trig extensively in order to figure out what design improvements we would like to implement. More importantly, we took our customers' feedback into consideration as well. With all that being said and done, we are proud to present Pattern 84 in its latest iteration, Pattern 84 2.0. The biggest change between 1.0 and 2.0 is the overall size and the H harness. Now, this went through several prototype changes, so we started off with this rough mock-up here held together with Cordura tape, which we then actually used out in the field for a couple months figuring out what else we wanted to add and change. We wanted to cut away a bunch of the excess, so the physical rig is actually slimmed up comparatively to the first iteration. Additionally, we wanted to make it swift clip compatible so that you could swap out different harnesses, just so the end user had a lot more options compared to hard sewn straps. So we cut down the overall height of the rig by about an inch on the top and about a half inch on the bottom, resulting in a much slimmer profile, which wraps around the body a lot better. Same with harness spacing, was moved in and again made swift clip compatible. This then resulted in our first functional prototype. This one, as you can see, we reduced the overall angle of the mag flap pouches, added in some more multi-tool pouches, but we weren't quite done there. There was a couple other subtle design changes from routing off the corners to then figuring out some more details on the flaps, which resulted in the final product, Pattern 84 2.0. The first change we made was getting rid of the pen flare pouch and replacing it with a clone of the multi-tool pouch from the other side of the rig. This just gives you a little more versatility. You can throw in another Glock mag, flashlight, multi-tool, or small medical supplies. The next thing that we changed was removing the pouch divider, mainly from customer feedback and use. This allows you to re-index mags, whether it be AK mags, SCAR mags, STAN eggs. There's just less of a hang-up hazard. Additionally, we then dialed in the elastic after removing that divider so that it'll function with everything from a single mag in a pouch all the way up to a double mag for most of your AK mags, SCAR mags, or even triple STAN eggs. Next, we angled the mag flaps as well. Now, this was done for two reasons. It slightly reduces a snag hazard from having just a 90 degree corner sticking out there on the side, but additionally, we thought it looked a lot more aesthetically pleasing, which is still important. We increased the size of the indexing tab here on the lip of the mag pouches. That way it just makes it just a touch easier for you to grab it with your gloved hands or if you're in sort of any quick situation where you really want to get that mag flap access quickly. Now probably the biggest change is when we decreased the overall height of the rig and we still kept the same overall carrying capacity as the original rig. Both your GP pouches are the exact same size, you can still hold the exact same amount of mags and you still have the same molly fields on both the sides. The thing you guys all asked for from 1.0 was making it H-harness compatible. So, we added swift clips, reduced the spacing, and then designed our own H-harness. We spent a lot of time dialing in the thickness of the pad to make sure that it would function well under rucks and while shouldering a rifle. With the addition of the H-harness, we wanted to keep the original map pouch design. We had to move the Velcro in so that you were able to hook one finger and still get access to that map pouch nice and easy, even if you changed up the height of the H-harness. Now that we've covered all the major design changes from Pattern 84 1.0 to Pattern 84 2.0, let's talk about what we kept the same. We kept the mag pouches identical, so it still fits everything that the original Pattern 84 1.0 could. We tested the compatibility of the magazine pouch to carry 6 mags of just about every magazine on the market. Whether it's your 40 round P mag, your AK mag, your STAN egg, your SCAR mag, your 25 round AR-10 mag, or your 20-round AR-10 mag. Additionally, it'll fit a lot more magazines that we don't have here, including Galil mags, G3 mags, along with 5.45 AK mags. The G3 mags are a little tight, by the way. One of our favorite features we kept from the original Pattern 84 rig was the overload capacity. So, in an emergency, it can fit up to 9 STAN eggs, 3 in each pouch. It'll be a little tight initially indexing them, but that'll loosen up over time as you use that elastic. Now, if you want to run a lighter load, it can also be run with just 1 magazine per pouch. It'll be a little loose with STAN eggs, but with the addition of more Velcro here, you can really get the flaps nice and secure, even on those smaller magazines. Something we kept the same from the original Pattern 84 1.0 was the GP pouch. The size is identical, the only thing we added was slightly lengthening that flap. This allows you to fit a full-size water bottle, some of your taller radios, along with grenades and medical supplies. We made 2.0 out of the same high-quality materials as 1.0. 1000D Cordura, NIR-compliant fabric, and our custom run of mesh. This last year, we've dialed in a lot of design changes we wanted to see, but it isn't the end of our iterative process. We're continuing to work on the design and would love to hear your feedback. If there are questions that weren't answered, let us know in the comments. We have some really exciting projects in the works for our YouTube channel that we can't wait to share. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon if you want to get notified of when we post. If you're not already signed up for Commando Pro, go sign up at commandostore.com/signup. It's completely free, you'll get exclusive content a couple of times a week, save 1% off for life, and even earn free shipping on orders over $150. Until next time, thank you for watching.